Hi guys! In this video, we are going to look over how to rotate shapes. When you select the shape, anchor points come out. And look carefully among them. You can find three arc points. Put your mouse on it, then the circle gauge for degree comes out. According to your point of view, there might be two or only one arc points that you can see in the screen. In this case, you need to adjust your screen to find more arc points. These three arc points are to rotate shapes. If you click the arc point and then drag, the shape is rotated. Each arc point rotates the shape in X, Y, and Z axis. If you are too young to know what X, Y, and Z axis are, then it would be better to try all three arc points one by one to figure out how it rotates with your eyes. There is one hidden tip in this function. When you click arc points and get your mouse closer to the shape, you can use snap degree. Snap, snap, snap. You can see the snap works by 22.5 degrees, 1/4 of a right angle. This function makes it more easy to rotate shapes in 90 degree and 180 degree sharply. If you get your mouse far from the shape, of course you can rotate it by 1 degree delicately. When the mouse is closer to the shape, when the mouse is far from the shape, you can see the rotation works differently. If you want to rotate the shape by 45 degrees precisely, then hold the shift key together. By holding the shift key, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, you can rotate the shape conveniently. Similar to the size of shape, you can input your number for the degree. Click the arc point, then the value boxes come out. Put the number you want in the value box. Then it will be rotated accordingly. If you put minus 35 degrees, it will be rotated counterclockwise. But the thing you gotta be cautious is that once you rotate the shape, the degree in the value box will be reset to zero. It doesn't record how much you have rotated before.
It's gone.
Then it might be hard to find where to go back. Hence, you need to remember the value how much you put, or send SOS sign to medical control Z. In Tinkercad, it is more convenient for you to remember how much degree you rotate the shape by.